Whenever I was working for long years for Qatar National Bank, that is the reason why Rasim said that I know finance part. But generally, from the beginning, I worked on front-end technologies. Currently, JavaScript and React.js are my experiences. Today, firstly, I'm gonna give you a quick introduction about what is React.js, and we will talk about prerequisites of React.js. Then we will talk about top web frameworks in 2020. Actually, this webinar is not only a React.js webinar. We will also talk about which point this world reached according to front-end technologies in 2020. So we will talk about most important front-end technologies, and we will make some live benchmarks. We will realize the latest situation of their usage, popularity, and market demand. After that, we will make a small demo, and we will see some coding examples about React.js. Then, after end of this session, we will understand React fundamentals, how to handle events, how to build components, how to render UI and debugging. So, what is React? React is an open source JavaScript library for creating user interfaces. React basically focus on UI, renders UI. It is only a technology for view layer. It is not a framework like Angular or other technologies. We will discuss what is framework and library a couple of slides later. But basically, React is called as a library, not a framework. It is developed by Facebook, as you know, in 2011. And they open sourced it in 2013. You can build fully functional web applications by using only React. React also known as React.js or React.js. As you know, there is another technology, React Native. This technology is used by mobile development, but React is only for web development. So, why React is a library, not a framework? Let's look at to its definitions. Basically, a framework is a software where you plug your code into. So you have a software, and it is a base structure. It is a main structure, and you have a couple of third-party codes, or you have a couple of new codes. You write your codes into this framework. So framework covers everything. A library is a software that you plug into your code. So you have a source code, and you use this library to plug into this whole structure. So if you look at this graph, it will be clearer. Framework here calls our code and calls a library, a third-party library. A library is called by framework or our code. This is the difference. So, according to this definition, React is a framework. Because, as you know, React is a whole structure. We are writing our code inside React. But in web technologies, to say a technology a framework, we expect something more. For example, there need to be some out-of-box routing, out-of-box MVC structure, and out-of-box dependency injection, out-of-box network capabilities. But React only renders your code and nothing more. So according to this definition, yeah, it's a framework, but in web technologies, as I said before, we expect more. For example, this this example will embody the difference. It will demonstrate us framework versus library. This example shows us different approaches, framework and library. In the Angular, Angular has built-in HTTP module that lets developers to easily make HTTP requests in an Angular app without using any third-party component. As you can see here, HTTP client module class from Angular's its own library. It is built-in out of box. When you install Angular, you got these HTTP features. But in the React, you have to use another third-party component to execute network requests like Fetch, Axios, or SuperAgent. This is the difference. Don't worry about it, because React is a really big environment. There are a lot of features for every kind of need. As you can see, for network requests, you can choose best one for your need. But Angular, the best practice in the Angular is using built-in libraries rather than third-party libraries. It is recommended one, but in the Angular, you have different opportunities. You can type Google and you can find a lot of different options for each of your need. For example, as you can see, NPM, let's jump into this example. Axios, using Axios, we will find first install the library with this code, npm install Axios, then import Axios in the code here. And we can directly start using Axios in our code. Very easy. So what is the prerequisites of React? As you know, a lot of developers want to learn this React, and there are a couple of prerequisites before starting React. Basic knowledge of HTML and CSS. As you know, you are creating basic structures of your web applications with HTML, and you are giving designs to this HTML with CSS. And 3 months experience in the JavaScript will be enough with ECMAScript 6 standards, because with ECMAScript 6, we can write more quality code. And how to use NPM is another important thing, because as you know, as I said before, React is using a lot of third-party libraries to do its job well. So we are installing these third-party libraries with NPM. Actually, there are a couple of codes to use NPM, and I think everybody can learn it in a couple of hours maybe. And DOM tree is another important thing for all web technologies. Again, it is better to learn what is DOM tree before starting each web technology, because as you know, browsers creating this DOM tree from HTML code and CSS and JavaScript code, and React, Angular, and other significant JavaScript libraries are manipulating this DOM tree. So these are ECMAScript 6 features that came to our life. For example, let and const are really important features. We define variables with these keywords. As you can see, var was already in our life, and we have now let and const. Var is global version. It is better to use let and const, especially const is the most powerful one, but when you define a variable with const, it can't be reassignable again, and let is can be reassignable, and it is functional scope, not global scope. Var is global scope, as you know. Arrow functions is another good coding practices, good coding method. Here is a code block without arrow function, and you can write this code with arrow function with only a single line, as you can see. And it is really powerful with some JavaScript functions like filter and map. Using arrow functions is really easy and decrease code lines. As you know, generally less code is more quality code. Here is ECMAScript 6 classes, and we have classes now. So you can define classes as we did before in the C sharp or Java. So yeah, JavaScript frameworks in 2020, there are server-side frameworks and front-end user-side frameworks. These are web frameworks in these years. There are a lot of other frameworks, but generally these are most popular ones. So firstly, why we need frameworks? Why don't we write everything with JavaScript, HTML or CSS? Because these technologies was built by really strong developers. These developers don't know only these technologies better than us, better than everyone. They are programming heroes. And these developers wanted to increase code quality and decrease cost of projects. So there are a lot of ready-to-use functions, ready-to-use features, ready-to-use templates in all of these frameworks. So if you don't need to write everything from scratch, why should you do this? There are a lot of really good, powerful, all bug solved frameworks. They are ready to use, they are free. So frameworks speed up the development and so save time. It gives us well-organized app structure because they forces us because of their files, because of their class structures. So it enforces to best practices to us. There are feature-rich applications and there are some advanced security features and ready-made code. So it is better to use frameworks if we can. For example, we will already talk about React, Angular and Vue.js. I wishly put here to jQuery. As you know, it is really important technology because jQuery filled the gap between vanilla JavaScript and our advanced front-end frameworks. There was a really big gap and jQuery filled this gap until this year. When you start to a big project in a company, probably you will see jQuery codes in these companies, in these projects, legacy areas. So it is better to learn again jQuery for existing web applications. Meteor is a full stack framework. Meteor, you write only once with JavaScript for both backend and frontend side. And there is no need for any REST API call because Meteor is already a full stack framework. Express.js is created on Node.js. There are a lot of ready to use functions and it is a little bit in industry standard in these days. Some of the ExpressJS development team members created CoA, and it is there is again really good speed up, very good performance modules features. It increased powerful of ExpressJS actually, because they understand that there are some unnecessary features in the ExpressJS, and they created some new templates to develop faster, and they solved a couple of bugs in the ExpressJS. But it is less configurable than ExpressJS because it is ready to use. And yep, that's all for JavaScript frameworks current situation. So when we look to front-end frameworks in 2020, we see really important and powerful three options. React, Vue.js, and Angular are really powerful options. They have its own pros and cons. For example, Angular, as you know, created by Google, and it is oldest one and most elder one. For example, its pros: code consistency is really good in Angular because, as I mentioned before, it is a complete framework. It is a whole ecosystem, so you don't need to type Google anything to find some libraries. Let me hide this thing. Okay. So there is built-in MVC architecture, and there is built-in dependency injection. As you know, once we start to use some services, some libraries, there need some connection things between these services. With dependency injection, we got separation of concerns neat very well. So Angular forces this separation of concerns principle to developers, and it has a modulation structure. Angular projects, we can think they are like a puzzle. So with this modularity, finding bugs, debugging piece of web applications is really easy. We can address a bug very easily because all of these modules are separated from each other. And as you know, once we are debugging millions of code, finding a bug inside this whole structure is sometimes get a little bit boring. But Angular is really powerful because of its modularity. Const learning curve is a little bit higher than others. As you know, it is a complete ecosystem and there are a lot of things to learn here. Performance is relatively lower than other options. Migration and backward compatibility is a little bit low in this technology. For example, if you wrote a web application and if you want to update your Angular version, probably there will be some defects, some unsuitable old codes in your new current version of Angular. So it is a little bit, it gives a little bit pain to all developers when we update Angular version. When to use, when to choose Angular? This is a really important question. Angular is your choice if you want to develop a large project and want to extend it with time. is suitable for enterprise applications, actually. And if your web application will be a feature-rich application, and if you want to update this web application time by time, so Angular will be a good choice. Yeah, React. Pros, great view layer. As you know, React do only one job, and it does one job really well. Backward compatibility, you don't need to think anything about the backward compatibility because it always guarantees that. Ubiquity and future proof. React is now everywhere, and it is really popular in these days. We will see existing statistics, and you will realize that it is really popular in all around the world. And learning efforts is relatively less than Angular, because, as you know, React basically using JavaScript, and Angular is using TypeScript. TypeScript has its own styles, has its own codes, but generally majority of the web developers already knows JavaScript. And data binding is one way, so once you change something in your UI, side effects will be less rather than two-way data binding. Performance is higher than Angular. It is a first class, there is a first class progressive web app support, and jobs is another powerful side of React. It is really popular in the market now. Easy to start a mobile project, because React Native is based on React.js. Majority of the code, majority of the structure is coming from React.js into the React Native. So after a couple of days searching the differences between React.js and React Native, you can start to a mobile application if you know React.js well. Const integration, as I mentioned before, it is a library basically. You need to learn which third-party component is better for your need. So there will be a lot of third-party components around your project. So integration is a little bit important issue for you. And but as I said before, there are a lot, it is a really big environment, so there are a lot of very well options for each of your need. So but yeah, integration is important thing to consider. React leaves developers to make choice, because in the Angular, as we saw in the our networking example, in the Angular, there is already one built-in, networking library. But in the React, you should choose your own way. So in the React applications, it is better to have a technical lead to direct other developers, because if each developer his own choice, project will be complicated day by day. So it will decrease reusable code. So it is better to take this decision with a team. So moving away from class-based components, because React is writing with functional components, It is JavaScript and React is generally using functional programming approach rather than object-oriented programming like C# and Java. So some developers maybe don't like it, maybe like it, it depends. G6 is a synthetic sugar of JavaScript. It is using by React to draw screens. You can write HTML codes inside the JavaScript code, and you can write JavaScript code inside HTML code. You can mix them. It is easy, but an item to learn at the end. When to choose React? React allows developing flexible projects with significant ecosystems, so nearly everywhere for every need. In the beginning, general idea was React is suitable for only startups, but now a lot of companies, very huge companies, are using React for its own enterprise applications also, because these technologies are still in progress. They are improving by very powerful companies. Facebook is still investing React day by day. Google is still investing Angular day by day. So they are getting better than before, day by day. And Vue.js Pro's approachable, easy to start. It is using basically JavaScript, and it is easier than all others. It is very learning curve is really low. Size, application size really few. It is very lightweight framework. Readability, code readability is really good. Performance is better than others. Popularity among developers are increasing day by day. It is really popular between developers, not in the market, between the developers. Maybe one day it will be the best one, but not today. We will see in the couple of slides later. Const, small community. It is developed by a small team, a small American-Chinese team. And over flexibility, yeah, this flexibility is the reason sometimes hard to manage. If you can change everything in your code, every library in your code, this over flexibility can be a really painful thing after for a large scale project. And lack of resources, as you know, it is still on progress technology. It is still developing, and React and Angular has really a big community currently. So once you face with a big issue, a complex issue, after you type it in the Google, yeah, you can find some solutions, but it will be not as much as React or Angular. When to use Vue.js is excellent. Vue.js is excellent if you need a lightweight framework with a simple learning curve. So there is three important subjects in the project management approach when choosing a framework. You should choose budget, scope, time, and schedule. If your budget is high, and if your scope is really big, and if you have enough time, Angular can be a good choice. If you have really few budget, and if your scope is not so much, and it is better to choose Vue.js, and React generally can be chosen by each condition. So let's make our own live benchmarks, we will firstly jump into Google Trends, and we will understand searching trends currently. Then we will see NPM trends. These are currently generally developer perspective. It is market perspective. We will see IT from IT Jobs Watch in the UK market rates, and we will then see Stack Overflow. Here is very important survey. I think majority of you knows Stack Overflow creates a survey each year, and hundreds, thousands of developers vote these technologies, these questions. So let's start with Google Trends. In the United Kingdom, last 12 months, search trends is like this. React is leader, as you can see. I put here to React Native because, as you know, React keyword is covers React Native also, so you can subtract it from React.js, and you will understand the real ratio of React. And here is Angular, here is Vue. Sometimes Vue is better than Angular, but generally still Angular is more popular in the United Kingdom. Let's see worldwide. In worldwide, React is again leader, and Angular is closer to React relatively to United Kingdom. So Vue.js is there. Again, React.js and Angular is again really close to each other. If you decrease React Native, subtract React Native from React. Yeah, this is popularity of these technologies and NPM trends. NPM trends, once we look at to NPM trends, you can see React is downloading so much, and its trend is increased the middle of this year, and there is a little bit decreasing this month. Vue.js, same with Angular. Here is another Angular library. Any questions so far?
No.
Okay.
Everything, I think, nice.
Okay. So let's jump into most important one. What is the market rates? These web applications is really professional web applications, and there is a very detailed numbers, very detailed analyze. Rank of React.js is increased according to last year, and here is its median daily rate. Once we look at to Angular, yeah, it decreased, its popularity is decreased according to last year. Daily rate is same. And Vue.js, it is getting popular day by day, and currently it is not as much as popular as React or Angular currently, and its median annual salary, let me contract IT Jobs. Yeah, here is contract. We already looked at the contract once. contract. So it is again contract. So yeah, it is getting popular day by day. Its rate is same with others. So Stack Overflow, let's get Stack Overflow. It is really important survey. Currently 2020 is not ready by Stack Overflow. So let's type to React in this. Yeah, web frameworks this year, I think it is usage ratios. jQuery is the most used framework previous year, as I mentioned before. React and Angular is used so much again. Vue.js is here, half of other options. And here is another popular React native mobile library. React Native, as I mentioned before, based on React, and its popularity is not so few. Most loved, dreaded, and wanted frameworks, React and Vue.js is same. They are loved and wanted. As you can see, here is Stack Overflow, its own analyze, and I think it is really important analyze. Here is this tree shows us relations between technology. As you can see, React Native, yeah, it is a responsive website, and we lost this. Yep. In the middle of each technology, JavaScript here, and Node.js and React.js is born from JavaScript, and React Native is developed on React.js. I think Angular is again here, TypeScript here. So yeah. As we can see in this market analysis and Google Trends and NPM Trends, currently React.js is the most popular one in the market and between developers. So as Rasim mentioned in the beginning of webinar, competition is really high. So I think, in my opinion, it is better to add React experience in your CV, so it will increase I think your chance to be hired. So these are until now we talked about general web concepts and 2020 what other options of React. And now we will jump into more technical side. We will talk about React features, how to code React, fundamentals of React. Firstly, we will talk about components. Component is the most important keyword of React, because every piece of the UI is component in the React. It is, as you can see, action button is a component here, and it is a instance of a class, basically. And this render method sends this action button component to the UI. So component is the core feature, core thing of the React. Here is a usage of a component, action button, text, and an action property. Components are separated, isolated from each other. They are reusable classes. For example, here there are a lot of components. For example, 1, 2, 3, or 4 are other components, and this is a web application, and you can see this layout. How designer designed this screen with this component. It is, it illustrates this component logic to us. For example, here is a network component, and we used other components inside this component, and all of them are, we write once this component and reused more than once. As you can see, again, here is another component, predictions component, and we used other child component, departure board, and here's another child component, trains. Here is a tree structure, actually. So, for example, class tweet, and we have a state. We will discuss what is state, what is render, a couple of slides later. And this render sends this React element, this React component to the screen. Yeah, there is a tree structure in all React applications, as we have just seen. So let's think about Twitter. If you want to develop an application like Twitter, how you would separate this screen into components? Firstly, I can see in the top of the screen a navigator, navbar component. It is separated from screen. There is a search bar, there is a navigation button, and there is action buttons and a settings menu button. And here is a profile component. It is again separated from screen, actually. You can isolate this piece from screen. And here is feed screen, feeds component. And in the feed component, you can like or you can tweet, forward this tweet also. So here is tree structure of a Twitter-like app. Yeah, virtual DOM is another really important concept of React. React uses a virtual DOM to increase its own performance. Angular directly uses real DOM. Real DOM, for example, let's see what is DOM. Yeah, this tree structure, for example, let me select one thing. Yeah, this is DOM tree. It is looking like HTML code, but it is not same with your HTML code. Browser takes your HTML code and makes some manipulations before rendering that. Angular directly manipulates this real DOM, and that is the reason why its performance is not high as high as React or Vue. Vue and React use virtual DOM. Virtual DOM is a copy of lightweight, very lightweight copy of real DOM, and it is stored in the memory. Once your UI changed, it directly updates virtual DOM, not directly updates this real DOM. For example, you clicked a button and for example, you liked something in the screen, you pressed heart button, and firstly, your virtual DOM will be updated. After this virtual DOM will be updated, and an algorithm in the background automatically will realize which part of the screen is changed, and it realized this part is changed, and it sends this only this piece to the real DOM. So each React app sends related updated piece of the real DOM, not whole tree, not whole web application will send to real DOM, only a related part. This illustration will embody whole whole approach of React. For example, once you press to tweet button, it will create a post service and API tweet message will be sent to server, and server returns us to payload. And this payload is catched from React code, and it triggers some events after result reach to our project. And after this state, after this code, change some UI in the screen. As I said before, you, for example, pressed a button, like or dislike or tweet, it triggers some post services. And after this post service will be succeeded, you want to change the behavior, change the visuality of the screen. So then firstly, virtual DOM will be changed by React mechanism. And after these changings was specified by React, it firstly executes a diff algorithm. Diff algorithm is understand differences between virtual DOM and real DOM, and only changed and affected parts will be sent to real DOM, and this real DOM will be updated, only related parts. So that's the reason why Vue and React has a really good performance, and this browser DOM will be seen in the screen. As you can see from here, here is a welcome welcome component. Here is a constructor because it's a class component. Here is a render method, and this render method sends UI piece with a JSX code to the screen. So always React renders this piece under the render function. Render function is a must to have a function for all React components. So before React, as you know, in when we are when we used jQuery or vanilla JavaScript, we were directly manipulating DOM tree. We were writing document.query selector, and we were directly manipulating DOM tree. But React does this job for us, so there is no need to add event listeners, add classes, or other query selectors. If you are using React, it does this job for us very well. JSX, as I mentioned before, it is a synthetic sugar of JavaScript. We can mix HTML and JavaScript codes, and we can use them with less code. For example, here is a code sample without JSX. It is a pure JavaScript code, and it is JSX version of it. JSX stands for JavaScript XML. So, as you can see, const element equal is a JavaScript code, but H1 tag is HTML code. So with JSX syntax, you can mix this thing. Props is another important concept. Props, if you want to pass a property from component to component, you have to use props keyword. Props is a special keyword for React, stands for properties. Here, as you can see, here is usage of props. For example, on click button, on click, this dot change for it. Change for it is here a prop. Let's see another example and it will be clearer for us. Action buttons text equal to book fight. And another prop on action is equal to some funk. On action here, action button is a component. And this component is using by another component. So there is a parent-child relationship. Some function property is not exist in the action button. It is passing by parent component inside action button. So on action, here is action button component here. It is a class component. And you can see this dot props dot on action usage is exists here. You can once user press button, on click method will be fired, and on action function that exists in the parent component will be triggered. For example, action button, as I mentioned before, action button is used by parent component. And text again will be passed to here. Action button, as you can see, it is implementation of detail of action button. This on action will be used in the on click function, and this text will be used in the between span text. Yeah, it is actually very straightforward to use. State is another important concept for React. State is different than prop. State is related with only components itself. You don't pass state from one component to another one. State, you can bind state to UI. If you update state with this set state function, it is another result function. If you update a state, as you can see, count is a state here. If you update count with set state, it will trigger this render method automatically, and your UI will be updated from the screen. So state has an important feature. You can update your UI with updating state, with set state command. So this usage is not a good usage. You can do it, but state is not exists for this kind of usage. If you want to assign something to some variable, you can use let, const, var, or other thing. But please use state once you want to update the UI with this result set state function. For example, here is a component class car, and here is constructor. As we saw in the previous example, here is two props. If you write a constructor here, you can get these two props inside your constructor. So you can initialize your variables in your screen with this constructor. Okay. So props versus state, let's see their differences. Props are immutable because it is passing a variable parent to child, component to component. So you can't change a prop. Prop has better performance because once you use props, it is constant. It never updates a screen once it's changed, because it can't be changed, and can be passed to child components. State is owned by its component. Local, scope, writable, mutable, editable, and has set state method to modify states. Change to state can be asynchronous, can only be passed as props. Again, state can be passed by props. So that's all for React coding methods. Coding concept is React is containing all of these features. They are really basic level and important things to learn before starting to code React.js. There are some other things. It will be better to learn them also, but currently these are enough to start developing web application by React. To establish a React development environment, firstly, you need to use Node.js. It is using for running JavaScript codes from outside of web applications. Node.js will execute our Node packets also. So we need to download Node.js from this site. It has its own installer file, so it automatically configures everything after pressing next. And we will use this package to establish our first React Native app. Then we will go to related folder to open our React application, and we will start our application server to debug our code. And I generally prefer to write my web applications with Visual Studio Code. It is, as you know, very lightweight, and there are a lot of extensions. Generally, I install Prettier. It formats our code. It gives different colors of each type of coding. So Prettier is a kind of industry standard now. And if you familiar with using Snit, it is the best one, I think, and the most popular one. So let's code. Any questions until now? Questions so far?
No question.
I think we don't have.
I think your slides is very clear. Very clear, yeah.
Yeah, I try to put every important thing in my presentation. Hope it is funny and you like that. So in the first beginning, firstly, I will go to my root folder, and I'm gonna create a React app. with this code. This code, this package will establish, will create an empty project with all configured, with all of its configurations. So it is really easy way to start a web application from scratch with this create React app feature or of MPX. And it is the name of my web application, and it will start to download all of the third-party libraries. Looks like it's no longer okay. So yeah, it created a folder inside here. Now currently downloading, it is more than 150 megabytes, and it will take a little bit time. So it is also downloading React itself, React DOM, React scripts, and other third-party libraries. As I mentioned before, React is a library, and it is working with a lot of third-party components. So this speed depends on your computer speed and network speed, as you know. Finalize. So if you look at here, I downloaded Debugger for Chrome. With this tool, you can debug your web applications inside your solution. You don't need to go browsers extensions. You can download it from Visual Studio, inside Visual Studio. And here is Prettier. 7 million download. And you can manipulate its options from here. For example, if you want to format your code, once you click Control S, there are a lot of properties here about Prettier, and you can change every feature. For example, default quotes will be double or single. You can choose from here. So yeah, here's happy hacking. Thank you. Let's see our project size, empty project size. It is 180. So currently I want to open this project folder. It's created by MPX. Looks IT. And it is, I started Visual Studio after selecting it. Yeah, here is our empty project structure. Let's execute this project firstly, then see default layout of screen. Then we will talk about details of each piece of project. So firstly, I'm gonna start npm. It is our application server, and we can run our application with this node package manager tool. Default port is 3000. Again, you can change that. Yeah, localhost 3000, as you can see, here is our local project. So let's jump into project files. Here is node modules. These are all downloaded piece of our React application. Babel connect pieces of each React project, connect pieces of third party, everything, and it creates a web application for us. And there are a lot of third party other components. There is built in SASS. And here is React itself. As we mentioned before, it is an open source application, and you can dive into details of React if you wish, if you have a lot of time. And public folder contains a couple of resources, global resources of project, and there is a manifest file that is a kind of configuration file for our project. We specify our project name, project short name, and icons, project icons, and source. For example, let's look at to index.html. As you know, it is a standard for all web applications. Here is body div id root. As you know, React creates single page web applications, and our whole project injects in this div. You have, for example, wrote more than 100 components, and you have a parent-child relationship. It is a tree. It is a component tree, as we saw in the presentation. This tree will be injected in here, div id root. But how? In the index.js, this code, React render, and there is two parameters. One is layout, which layout you want to inject what. I want to inject this thing inside this UI element. So this code takes this app component and puts it inside this root. So let's look at the app, because app is the root of the tree currently. And app, here is app, app.js. It is a function component, and I will I will change it to class component a couple of minutes later. Okay, and it returns something. Here you can see, and there is a class name app. I think some of you know CSS. We use CSS codes with class name. Actually, it is class in the HTML, and it is class name in the JavaScript. So here is import app CSS and React from React. as you saw before, they are all node modules. React is here, and we important React from node package we just saw. And here is import CSS. Import CSS is here, and here is some CSS codes to manipulate screen visuality. And each return, each component should have one root UI container. For example, if I write another div here, it will crash my screen because I can't do that. I can have only one root element under this return method. I put it, it will be no problem. So class name app header, there's a header, image source. For example, here are some other basic HTML and CSS codes. For example, is there any example for here? No, we will write it. For example, let's see to CSS file. Here is a media query. As you know, media query is really important for responsive web design. And it is de facto for responsive web design. And for example, we can change this code, for example, and what are the alternative? Alternate bot, infinite reverse, for example, let's ease what's happening. And I will put it to 5. It is triggering once and it is getting lower and lower. I will put it 1. Once you do same thing, you can play with this solution. You can change everything. And for example, it is infinite. I will change it. It will do it once and stop, for example. This is basically a React application. Let me delete, for example, existing code. And I'm gonna delete it also. I will save it. It will be empty. And I will write some new functions. So I'm gonna change it to class component. React.component. I have to write render method. And so as you can see, function component is turned to class component very easily. So I'm gonna add some HTML code. Here is basically a div and a header. For example, I can type some inline styling. As you know, there are two main types of styling, inline styling and styling with file. As you can see, it is outer styling codes. Generally, I use separated styling files for each component. For example, if I write another, if I create another another component like car.js, for example, it is better to create a car CSS file, and after creating that, import to this CSS file, and it is, I think, best practices. Otherwise, it will be unmanageable with inline CSS files, inline CSS codes, and it isn't reusable. Inline CSS are not reusable because, for example, I can use this thing, for example, this thing inside another UI element too. I can use it. So inline styling is not recommended, but you can type inline styling like this. Like this, you can type inline styling, but it is not recommended one. As I said before, it is better to write styling with this classes definitions. As you know, this dot is used by classes and DS is used for IDs. For example, if you want to use ID, you can, for example, root div. You can give I think it is active, but you can, for example, if you press to F12 in the developer, you can click all of the HTML3 in your code, and you can see each of the UI properties inside this code. For example, you can activate or deactivate of all components, or you can you can select other properties here. For example, can let me add font size, and here you can change all of things from here, or you can give background colors. Once you saw your UI, you can copy this thing into your code, and as you can see, you can change UI of your projects. For example, let's add an image, for example. Let's type it. This one looks good.
By the way, Gürkan, we finished our times. Everybody tired, I think. Slowly, if we are able to finish. Well, the car is.
Rasim, we can continue if you wish, or we can make these coding examples in another session, whatever you want.
Yeah, By the way, the React in itself, it is really big framework, like other frameworks like AngularJS. It is not possible to finish in a one shot, but the important things, you know, what they showed us so far, they were the basic things, and you teach us how to go forward. I think on it we can improve ourselves. Also, we are planning some workshop about it. On these days, you are so busy in your free times. If I find the time, I will organize one workshop about it. And if anybody wants to go deeply, they can join. But I think this evening, we can leave it here. And we can jump to question and answer session. If they have any question, we may try to answer.
Yep.
It will be much better, I think. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Go for it. I think you want to do one last thing. Okay. I am curious about it.
There are a lot of features in the React in the coding perspective. There are some industry standards when coding, best practices, and it is really better to handle all of these things in a good session, in another session. So maybe after this session, every attendees will understand how to create an enterprise React app, and with its own best practices, we will demonstrate one by one, and we will code together. So we can continue with a separated coding session. It will be great. So yeah. Currently, I try to share my knowledge about industry, web development in 2020, what is React, fundamentals, how to code with React. It is, I think, more than enough. Coding is very simple and very similar with JavaScript, but it is not same with vanilla JavaScript. There are some best practices. In the professional life, in big projects, there are different approaches for React web applications. So I really appreciate to share this knowledge with other developer friends in another session. So it is, I think, time to questions.
Yeah. By the way, are you able to put this coding sample to GitHub, to your GitHub?
Yeah, I can code is very simple, and I can put every important UI element usage into GitHub. For example, lists, buttons, grid tables. I will create a small project for you, and I will push it to GitHub.
Great. And,
if you want to create your own web applications, there will be a lot of ready-to-copy-paste codes for you.
Yeah, ready-to-use code, yeah. That would be good. By the way, in my idea, when you jump to browser, especially for the developer tools, you know, you showed something on the web page. What we see, we are able to update everything. You know, just keep in your mind, you know, as a business logic, you cannot trust front end coding. You know, better to use that kind of. Better to use front-end skills for the presentation, for the rendering side, to create nice and user-friendly website. Otherwise, you have to validate all of your code at the backend side. As the Gurhan showed us, you are able to change your styles, you are able to change all of the DOM objects. You can manipulate with the JavaScript every kind of objects on the web page. Keep in your mind. Yeah, that's all from me as well. Yes, do you have any question, guys? How Next.js is different from React.js? Gürhan, I think I can answer this question because I use also Next.js, also Nest.js. There are so many backend-based frontend, backend-based framework, JavaScript framework on the market. Next.js, you can develop microservice, even microservice as well. It is completely different than the React.js, Angular.js, and Vue.js. Next.js for the backend development. You can develop one website from scratch with its database management, its microservice implementation. You can implement REST API with Next.js, but with React, you cannot develop one REST API. You cannot implement any microservice, just for the presentation layer. Okay, Next.js works on the business layer, but React.js works on the presentation layer. This is the big difference between them. And Nuxt.js as well, yeah.
No, Nuxt.js is a little bit different. It is, okay. It allows you, as far as I remember, it works with Vue.js. It's an extension like Vue.js, so you can generate projects with it. So you need to answer some questions, and you are creating your site, you are compiling it, and if you want, you can generate static pages with Next.js very easily, and all of your pages will be static, so you will be deploying just your HTML files. So it depends on your business usage. I mean, if you need static sites, you need static sites, but you need dynamic pages, then you may want to use Next.js. It's a different technology.
Yes, another question, guys. Yeah, I think we don't have any questions. And if you don't have any question, we are about to finish the event. By the way, we are running so much workshops about trendy technologies. You can follow, you are already following our events. Keep in touch. If you have any suggestion as an event, you can let us know, and we are trying to find the right guys from the market as well, because we are really interested in technological trends.
Thanks for listening.
Thank you very much, Gürhan. It was very informative. Thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you, Gürhan. And thank you, guys. That was nice to see you. See you on next event.
Yep.
Thank you.
Bye. Good afternoon. Good afternoon.